better safe than sorry.
Give me a second to let my eyes adjust to that. beeping makes me feel a little creepy. This is a lot easier than lab.
Thank you. Dr. Applebaum has pronounced me in perfect health. For a man 20 years my senior, I must face the facts. The gray hairs, the wrinkles, they are not figments of the imagination. I can draw only one reasonable conclusion. It is the elusive fractional errors of the shrinking process which are the cause. Trudy has asked that I discontinue my experiments, but what choice do I have? If I quit now, I will have nothing. What will I be other than a failed inventor and scientist with no discoveries to his name, unable even to teach the basics of physics to a gaggle of hormonal teenagers? No! If this means that I must sacrifice 20 years of my life, then so be it.
Thank you. believes that his entire life is a big failure, he sure did accomplish some pretty impressive things. Not that I'm letting him off the hook for this whole getting us kidnapped trunk and then left for dead in this yard thing.
This time you've gone too far, Wendell Tully. You've done the unthinkable, trespassed the unforgivable. You missed Thanksgiving dinner. Who can blame Trudy? I know that I pushed things to the breaking point and that she has grit her teeth and borne it. She told me that she could not bear to watch me destroy my life, let alone hers, the children's, in single-minded pursuit of this technology. Never in all the years of knowing her has she given me such a cold, immovable ultimatum. My science or my family. But if only she could see. I am doing this for them. I understand it has been hard. It has been harder on no one more than myself. If only I had more time. If I could just prove to them the wonders that are so, so close now, they would understand, wouldn't they? And if they did not, perhaps they never understood me at all.
Taking a look around.
Thank you.
Those aphids look like they have things to do and people to see. That tastes surprisingly not terrible. Wolf spider over here! Creepy. light. Burn back the shadows and turn away the inky depths of the night. Watch where you stick that nose, Weevil.
Science!
It is nice to see a friendly face around here. How can I help you today? I knew I could count on you. Please hold while I update my files. Here we go. Processing. Whew! Better than ever. My diagnostic module is now restored. Analysis shows the spacer suffered a catastrophic failure in the embiggening cell. If only. Sadly, I can only explain its function. The embiggening cell stores and regulates interatomic energy transfer during the spacing expansion phase of the spacer. Put simply, it controls the rate of growth of the subject and prevents overexpansion, which can be quite messy. Yes. If the subject's rate of growth is not precisely regulated, overexpansion will cause bioorganic subjects, such as yourself, to pop like a gremlin in a microwave! Scientifically speaking, of course. There is both good news and bad news. Which would you like to have first? All natural flavoring is not, strictly speaking, natural. Now you know! The good news is that I have a spare cell here. The bad news, it is empty. As they say, when life gives you lemons, close your eyes and imagine it's a delicious lemon crime. But I can provide you with instructions. The cell must be filled with a special mixture, a cocktail, if you will. Another breakthrough invention by Dr. Tully. Hold, please, while I push the recipe for the embiggening cocktail to your scabby. Processing. Error. Missing directory. The directory you attempted to copy does not exist. Boo-doo-doo. Cheese and fries. It appears the formula for the embiggening cocktail is not in my memory. It must be on one of the remaining super chips. We will need that recipe in order to fill the embiggening cell and send you home. I am sorry. It seems like the forces of nature are trying to keep you in this yard. But I believe you are here for a reason. Hold on to the empty cell for me. And when you feel ready, retrieve another super chip to see if we can piece this puzzle together. Have an exponentially great evening! Have to keep things clean. There's experimentation to be done.
Good thing I'm hungry. Aphid on the move. That's not so bad.
Oh, Oh, ugh. I guess that's why they call you a stink bug.
Body mass readout is an acceptable range. The skin fold degradation is minimal.
Specimen vitals are stable and holding. Looks like we've done it.
Great job, everyone. Let's set up 3 more trials for replication.
Sorry to crash your party. The Defense Department has arrived early to discuss Project Orc. The director needs you to be present at the meeting.
Not sure what's worse, our director or a 3-hour meeting with the military.
That wasn't my favorite brand of nightmare.
You know, I do suppose being a lab experiment in my dreams is a summation of my daily existence. So the military-industrial complex shrunk me down and then prodded me like a lab animal. My life is a geopolitical nightmare. Perfect.
It's pretty good.
Keep that nose to yourself. At least it's clean. Ish.
Safe than sorry.
Science!
Poor thing. What we can find.
I'm gonna bark if this mole keeps spewing that gas. This venous flow needs to be stopped.
infected. Stay away.
Eureka! I've always wanted to say that. Spiderling here! I shall name it... Doug Jr.